Wendy, wake up.
Eddie, is that you?
No, it's me. It's Frank.
Oh, Frank. The door was open. I didn't think Graham would mind.
I'm sure he won't. What are you doing here?
Looking for Stephen, but I just ran out of steam. And the door was open. Have you listened to the radio? I thought I heard him on the radio before.
It's all over the valley. Don't you get that? This isn't some abstract thing. Whatever came down into the tower has got out. They've quarantined the whole valley.
It's right here in the observatory.
It's out in the world. It's adapting and spreading. Do you understand?
No, we can't turn it away.
What's he talking about?
I don't know, Ken. But if he's on the radio, we can try and reach him on the CB. You go to Stephen's house, and if I get hold of him, I'll tell him to come and find you.
Come on, you stupid bastard. Come on, now. Come on. Ah, damn bloody thing! Jesus! Come on, not now! Jesus, come on, you bastard! Start, you bastard! Come on! Ah!
Stephen? Stephen, are you here? It's your mother. Answer me. Stephen! Stephen, where's Kate? Are you here?
Shh, 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 shh.
Stephen? I can hear the planes. It's the government coming to rescue us. You can come out now. It's all going to be all right. I can hear the jets coming. It's like when Eddie came home. It's like your dad coming home again.
I messed up, Frank, but I'd done my time. They shouldn't keep on punishing me.
Some folk won't let go, Reese, and they've got nothing better to do than to poke their noses into other people's business. Nothing you can do about it, son.
I'm doing a good job. I'm working hard. I swear, Mrs. Graves thinks I'll start nicking stuff if she turns about for a second.
This is all right. She's one of the good ones.
Yeah, well, she's not exactly honest with her husband about what she gets up to.
None of that. You're angry about people judging you. Don't be so fast to judge others.
I'm sorry, Frank.
Keep your gob shut, your nose clean, and your head down. Do you think you can manage that?
Gob, nose, head. Got it.
And steer clear of that Rachel girl. If I've seen you two making eyes at each other, then so's her dad. And you don't want Sam Baker coming round after you. Now, pass me that socket spanner and we'll see if we can get this wheel back on.
Can you see the observatory from there?
That's over the ridge, just past the windmill. Oh. You want to live near the station in case you need a quick getaway?
Something like that. So you and Stephen, I'm sensing there's not a lot of love lost there, huh?
That's between him, me, and the cows.
You're gonna have to explain that one for me.
It's nobody else's business. Look, you seem all right to me. You don't want to worry about that lot in the village.
Provided I'm left alone, I'm happy. Stephen's the one who likes to be at the center of things.
No change there, then.
Francis Appleton. You are a bad man. No wonder your sister won't talk to you.
You could see how the light was following the cellular structure of its wings. The neurosimplicity of the insects seems to prevent a full-blown infestation, so there's none of the hemorrhaging I'm seeing in the birds. But Stephen's wrong. This isn't an attack. It's a byproduct of the attempt to communicate. It's getting smarter. It's learning as it adapts. I'm confident of a breakthrough soon.
Breaker, Breaker 9, calling on 9. This is Lost Cowboy looking for anyone out there. Hello? Breaker 1-9, Breaker traveling Sherlock. Charlie, you out there? Over.
Hello? My family, my wife and kids. You know perfectly well what you've got to do. I can't do it. Don't ask me to do it. You're asking me to sign their death warrant, my own family. Damn it, don't you think I'm aware of that? I'll still be here when you drop the fucking stuff.
No.
Don't you lecture me about sacrifice, you spineless little shit.
Stupid bastards!
If you're so full of ideas, you come here and try dealing with it. Tell them the time when we had a choice is over. Tell them to do it. You've got to do it now.
It just seems a bit odd, that's all. She's just over the hill. Why can't we go and collect her?
You heard the radio. Try to minimise contact with different groups of people. It might be spreading that way. Besides, Father Jeremy told me that Lizzie Grave said they're all fine. They're still planning on putting on their show.
So how does Father Jeremy know what's going on at the camp if we're all supposed to be staying at home?
A special dispensation for the clergy or something. I'm sure Rachel will be all right. She seems to live at the camp these days anyway.
She's 16, Sam. It's going to happen. I was pregnant when I was 17.
Yeah, well, that's why I'm worried about what Rachel gets up to. Come on, give me that other case. We'll still be here at midnight if we don't get a bloody move on.
Can't understand why the car wouldn't stop. I'll have to get someone out to take a look at it.
As a semi-professional, yes, I suppose you could call it that. Well, we run a club here, a mix of hobby stargazers and more serious scientists. They sometimes let us use the observatory telescopes, but normally it's just a back garden sort of thing. Well, no, that's the thing. It's not like you need the Jodrell Bank to see it. There's just too many of them. Of course I'm serious. Go outside and count them. It's Orion, for God's sake. It's not difficult to find. Well, you tell me how many bloody stars are supposed to be on a belt, then.
You knew?
Wade called me in about 6 weeks after, once he thought I could cope with knowing. Can I ever repay you for what you did?
She was a good woman, Frank.
The best.
You should come back to church. Back to the community. You're missed.
I hate him, Father. I can't get down on my knees and pretend otherwise. And I don't understand why you don't hate him, too.
I try my hardest not to, Frank. Goes against the job description somewhat. Faith is the assurance of things hoped for. The conviction of things not seen. We have to trust him. Even when his methods are hidden from view. Maybe see you on Sunday.
Up on Stephen. He doesn't understand. Even if he were here to experience it directly, I'm still not sure he would. There has to be a way of consolidating, of offering reciprocal amplification to this signal. Radio telescope in Tower 6 is burned out. The background radiation coming in from the Penrose region is off the scale. It's like mathematics is bending along with the light. Everything is bathed in a strange glow. My face is still numb from the burn.
How's your sister, Frank?
We've not spoken since the funeral.
Ah, I see. Well, listen, I did rather wonder if you might do me a bit of a favor and check in on her, see if she's all right.
Dr. Wade, if they drop the bomb, there'd be no left but cockroaches and Wendy Boyles.
It's a bit odd, really. There's an old chap, John Coles, regular visitor at Lakeside, went walkabout sometime last night. Now it appears Mrs. Boughton has done the same.
Enid? Well, that'd be clever. They amputated her leg last spring.
Yes, that's the thing. I've also got a surgery full of people with nosebleeds and headaches. The council are saying influenza, but I've been practicing for 35 years and I'm not convinced. I just wondered if you might pop by and see her.
Even if I did, do you really think she'd let me in?
Fine. Forget it. I'll see her. Leave it to me. Oh, and Frank, call the hospital and get them to collect all this stuff. It's been 8 months.
Bloody England. You can't just stop the train, stop people travelling about the place. I don't like it, Frank. I don't like it at all.
Well, nobody likes it. No sense sweating cobs over it.
Folk all riled about it, giving me grief. I didn't stop the bloody trains, did I? And did they give me any warning? No, they bloody didn't. Yesterday, it's all like keep them calm, Howard, minor disruptions, and today it's all government edicts and not until further notice, and you'll manage. Half the village has vanished.
It's a couple of people. It's hardly half the village.
Oh, right now. You forget, I've seen things. I was in the Falklands. I tell you, I got out the old air raid siren to test it this morning.
Air raid siren? What on earth are you going to do with one of those?
I found it in the station storeroom. Took it home, stuck it under the bed. Thought it might be worth something one day. Oh, damn it!
It's all right. It's just a nosebleed. Here, here's my hanky. It's clean.
Oh, thanks, Frank, thanks. It's been going like a bloody drain all day.
Thank you.
All the power spiked with the last discharge and then went out again, and I could see the aurora dancing around Tower 6. At the same time, the headache intensified, and I think I began to hallucinate. Old and new memories are clashing and tumbling around me. We're on the cusp of a breakthrough. I can feel it.
Miss Graham.
Morning, Frank.
You look a little out of breath. What's up?
Bloody observatory gates have failed. I came to see if I could borrow a ladder.
Bloody hell, there's a 12-foot drop the other side of that wall.
I'm old, but I'm not useless, no. Can I borrow the ladder?
No one said you were useless. Reese?
Hi, Frank.
Fetch Graham the ladder, will you, lad? It's round the side of the barn.
Will do.
And you be careful. I don't want Stephen Appleton coming mithering round here because you've broken your neck.
What are we doing?
What are you up to?
Get out of my way. This is important.
You've been with Lizzie. You mess with her, I'll knock your bloody block off, son.
I need to track the pattern. It's critical.
What are you talking about, Stephen? People are sick. Birds are dying. My cows are dead. Where's Kate?
Still up at the tower for all I know. I could recalibrate the radial coordinates on the primary oscillators. If that holds up...
Stephen, where's Kate? What's going on?
Just keep out of my way.
You never mentioned anything about them sickening yesterday.
I checked them last night on the way back and they were fine. I woke up this morning and the whole lot had gone. Tell me, Charlie, have you heard any birds today?
Well, I've not really been paying any attention.
That sister of mine reckons they're dropping out the sky all round the Rican. And Dr. Wade reckons there's sick folk all over the village.
Meg said not to bother trying to get deliveries out. Said the quarantine in the whole valley. I reckon it's best we just sit it out. It'll all come right, Frank.
This'll all come right?
Yeah, right. I am sorry about your cows, Frank. But when things settle down, they'll see you all right. There's got to be provision for this sort of thing.
You want to listen to the radio more? Things don't seem like they're settling down at all. I tell you, Charlie, something big is happening.